Hi everyone, it's Matt from Fisher Electronics here. Wanted to do another video. This time what we've got on the floor is we've got a Samsung QLED. This is their actually Q8 series. But we've got it hooked up to our antenna and a Yamaha soundbar here. But with our antenna, we've got it hooked up to a Tivo box. This is one of their bolt boxes. And wanted to go over information on how to program your universal Samsung One remote so that it would control your, in this case, Tivo box, or your cable box or satellite box in your house. The remote from Samsung is going to look something like this. So I'm going to use this remote, and we're going to set this up for this Tivo box in this case. You're going to start by hitting your home button. When you do that, you're going to see this appear on your screen. What you want to do is use these arrows. They're not arrows necessarily, it's basically a circle. This is left, right, down, up, and the center point between that circle, that's enter, that's select. So we're going to arrow over to the left, and we're going to go all the way to source. And up in here, this is our source menu of all our sources on the television. Unknown is what it says right now for HDMI 1. That's where the Tivo box is at. And then there's our soundbar, and these are other inputs and different things. But we're going to go all the way to universal remote, because we want to set this up for the soundbar. So it says universal remote setup. Okay, well, let's start it. We're going to set up, in this case, I'm going to say the Tivo is a cable or satellite box, because it's definitely more of that than any of those other choices. So I'm going to select that. Okay, is it plugged in to the TV directly or home theater? Well, I have it plugged into the TV directly, so I'm going to select that. All right, enter your zip code. Okay, I've done that. It knows where I'm at. Now in here, it is none of these services, so I'm going to select my service provider is not listed. And in this section also, it's none of these. So the way you get around this is you go up all the way up to the top, search for your service provider. And here I'm just going to punch in, okay, Tivo. Bear with me as I'm looking at both screens. Okay, T-I-V-O. Done. Okay, it sees Tivo, so I'm going to select that. And then, okay, it's plugged into the HDMI 1 port, so I'm going to select that. Gets a check. So now it's going to say, okay, select channel up or down, because we're going to test it. I'm going to hit channel up. Oh, it changed it. All right. It says, did the channel change? I'm going to scroll down and say, yes, it did. Setup is complete. Okay, I'm going to hit done. So now, it's going to bring us back to this menu. I'm going to arrow all the way to the left to our source. And now you see it says, okay, that's Tivo. So I'm going to select Tivo. And now, instead of using your Tivo remote to change channels, you can use this Samsung One remote, the channel, and this is these are rocker switches. You're just going to rock it up and down, and same with volume. When I go up, hey, it changed my Tivo's channel. How about that? Same thing with down. So now you can take away your Tivo remote or whatever remote for your cable or satellite and use this remote to set it up. As far as specific features and how to access different things, it's different with everybody's cable boxes and things. The main purpose of this video is going through that setup and saying, okay, how do I get this remote to be programmed to my cable box or satellite box or, well, in this case, Tivo box. I do know with Spectrum, I was at a client's house installing one of these, and I believe the command to bring up the DVR was show list. You can use this microphone and talk to it to change channels or different things. If I make a change here real quick, I'm just going to go to our TV source right now, our antenna, but if you watch, I'm going to use this microphone. Channel 5-1. And now you see the TV changed to 5-1. Okay, why am I saying channel 5-1? We have an over-the-air antenna here. We don't have a cable or satellite getting it that way, more of the cord cutting generation. So this is all off of our antenna. So that's why antenna stations being digital are going to be all be decimal point numbers, 3.1 or whatever, 4.1, you know, could be 50 or 100.1, but that's what's going to happen with an antenna. So that's the basic features on this as far as using this remote to get it programmed to your equipment. Any questions or comments, put them in the comments section below, and hopefully this helps make it a little bit easier or gets you a little better idea on how to make this remote to program it for your equipment. You can visit us at fisherelectronics.net, and any comments or suggestions, drop them down below. Thanks and have a good day.